Belinda presents this unabridged recording of Super Good Skills, almost, written by Liz Pichon and read by Russell Tovey.
Mr. Fullerman has been in a surprisingly gloomy mood this week. I don't know why. You'd think he'd be happy, as it's almost the end of term. Mr. Fullerman being gloomy. Off the floor, please. Morning class 5F. Everyone. Hurry up. I know I am. Yippee! My nearly end of term leap of joy. Mr. Fullerman keeps sighing and frowning and then saying things like, which part of sit down do you not understand? Please push your chairs in, don't scrape them. No balancing books on heads. Pens are for writing and drawing. What are they for? I think Mr. Fullerman was expecting us all to say, writing and drawing, sir. But Brad Galloway decided they made excellent drumsticks as well and demonstrated with a spectacular drum roll on his desk. Put the pens down, Brad. So he did, but not in a sensible way. The pens went flying through the air and narrowly missed Amber, Leroy and Mr. Fullerman. Uh-oh. Brad got sent to sit outside the classroom and think about how silly he'd been. For the rest of the lesson, we all had to sit in silence, which wasn't easy for me to do as my head was so stuffed full of things to talk about. Dude 3. Drawing, cat or dog? It was even harder to concentrate as Brad kept appearing at the door when Mr. Fullerman wasn't looking. I tried not to laugh, but Mr. Fullerman's face wasn't helping. It gave me an idea for some drawings. Anyone who doesn't like cake is a twit. Ha ha. Which was a lot more entertaining than doing my worksheets, that's for sure. Break time. Derek's already waiting for me. We have to finish a very important conversation from this morning about a big decision. When I see Derek, straight away I ask him, have you made your mind up? No, I can't decide what to do. It's tricky to choose. Well, we need to sort it out soon. This is important. I know. I wish we had more time. As we're discussing what to do, more of our friends come over. That sounds serious, Solid says. It is serious. It could be the difference between having a good band practice and a terrible one. Norman hears the words band practice and looks up. I haven't missed band practice, have I? No, sorry, Norman, we haven't had a chance to talk to you about anything yet. We need to decide on something really important, I add dramatically. While I'm trying to think of the best way to tell Norman, Marcus butts in. What are you two going on about? If you had to make this decision, Marcus, you'd be exactly the same. It'd probably be a lot worse. We might be able to help you if you tell us, Solid says.
Go on,
Florence calls out. We have to choose something, Derek explains.
Choose what?
Calm down, Marcus. We have to... Mr. Sprocket blows the whistle for end of break.
Hurry up,
Marcus shouts.
Okay. We have to decide what flavour crunchy alien snacks to have at our band practice. Is that it?
Marcus walks off in a huff like we've wasted his time. Amy and Florence are pulling faces too. Norman says, phew, I thought you might want a new drummer. No way, I assure him. It's serious. Remember when the only snack we had was a packet of dead fly biscuits? I remind Derek and Norman. Flashback. Before. After. Dead fly biscuits are what Grandad Bob calls Garibaldi biscuits because the little currants sandwiched in between them look a bit like dead flies. Dead fly biscuits don't contain dead flies. Oh, how could we forget? Worst band practice ever, Derek shudders. Even I don't like those biscuits, Norman agrees. Yuck! I think everyone understands why choosing the right snack is so important now. Everyone, apart from Amy, who still thinks my snack dilemma is stupid. I know this because when I sit down in class, she tells me, honestly, who gets that worked up about what flavour snack to have? It's nuts. Crisps, actually. Crunchy alien ones, I say, trying to make a joke. Hilarious, Amy says, but not in a funny way. I should probably just stop talking about the snacks and keep my mouth shut, but for some reason I don't. The problem is, I really like the cheesy feet flavour alien snacks. You know, the ones shaped like massive feet. But Derek likes the pickled onion flavour. And now we've found out about two new flavours. Smoky chicken and a very interesting sounding chip and ketchup flavour that could be amazing. But we don't know yet because we haven't had a chance to try them. They all sound disgusting, Amy tells me, pulling a face. Cheesy feet flavour sounds disgusting, but they're actually delicious, I point out. My mum hardly ever asks what snacks we want, so I don't want to miss out. Do you see why it's so important now? Not really. Awkward silence. I'm trying to think of something else to say when Amy asks me a question. Tom, is your band still called Dog Zombies? Yes. Do you practice a lot then? Loads. If you want to be the best band in the world like we do, it's important. I may have exaggerated a bit. When's your next band practice then? I don't know yet. Oh, I thought you said you practice all the time. We do. We'll probably get together this week. Well, at least the snacks are sorted. Exactly. Marcus leans back in his chair and tries to tell Amy that Dog Zombies are a rubbish band.
Rubbish band.
I ignore him and take out my school planner. Then, in a very organised and sensible way, I write in big letters, hoping that Amy will see what I've written. Urgent and very important. Arrange day for band practice. Far more important than snacks. Go for cheesy feet and pickled onion flavour. I add that last bit in tiny letters underneath. There. I've made a decision. All done now. The end. I don't have to think about snacks at all anymore. Well, maybe just a little bit. Imagine what other snacks and flavours there could be. What's in the bowl? Crispy star and cheese nibbles. Spicy alien? Salt and onion shells. Chocolate-covered worms with sprinkles. Yum! Sausage and sock flavour. Sometimes when Mr. Fullerman comes back from break, if he's had a nice cup of tea and a biscuit, he can be all friendly and jolly. But not today. Sit down and no more playing with pens, Brad. That goes for all of you, he says in a really stern voice. Now, as there's only one more day left of school, I have something else planned. A murmur goes around and we think, hooray! At last, something fun to do. Today we're playing fun games. Yes! But that doesn't last long. Inside these folders is work that needs to be completed by the end of the holidays. If your folder is empty, give yourself a pat on the back. I look over to Marcus Meldrew, who starts doing some kind of weird dance. Why are you doing that? I ask.
I've done all my work, so I'm giving myself a pat on the back.
He stops when Mr. Fullerman hands him a folder stuffed with paper.
This needs to be finished, Marcus. Huh? But, sir...
No buts, Mr. Fullerman says. Some kids start laughing because Mr. Fullerman has just said the word buts really loudly.
Hee hee hee! Ha ha ha! Hee hee!
A full-on beady-eyed glare puts a stop to that pretty fast. Marcus is really fed up. You can tell from his face what he's thinking, which gives me another idea for some drawings. So, I draw Marcus Meldrew.
I know I'm a twit.
Mr. Fullerman has been walking around the class handing out folders, but there's nothing for me yet. I carry on with my game until suddenly he's standing in front of me and holding up another folder. You're one of the few people with no work to finish at all, Mr. Fullerman tells me.
Wow, that's good. I was sure I had some stuff left to do.
But I'm not going to argue with Mr. Fullerman. To make sure Marcus can hear me, I make a big point of saying loudly, "Thanks, sir. I tried my best. Does that mean I get to do fun things now?" "Sorry, Tom. I'm not talking to you. This is Amy's folder. Here's yours. It's quite full." Oh, so it is. I have so many bits of work I haven't finished that they spill out everywhere.
"You have even more than I do," Marcus says, laughing.
"Well done, Amy. You two need to get on with it," Mr. Fullerman says.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.